I walk up to the line of scrimmage.
Shaking out the foot, man. Pre-snap,
I look to see where this pro slot. I think back to what Coach talked about all week. Hear the linebackers yell out, strong, solid call.
Center, Mike Bryant, 33.
Within every war, there are battles.
There are battles.
No battle,
too small.
No inch.
No inch, not worth fighting for.
We are individual, but we fight together.
When it comes down to it, it's me.
It's me
against him.
Number 1 D. Tonight, they'll try to stop the Tigers' two-headed quarterback, Matt Flynn and Ryan Perilou. Just 80 miles from its Baton Rouge campus, number 2 LSU faces number 1 Ohio State in the All-State BCS National Championship.
Ohio State travels as well, if not better, than any school in the country. The Buckeye faithful, well represented. Sean Godet to kick it away, Ray Small. Set to return it for Ohio State. And the All-State BCS National Championship game is underway. This is Jamario O'Neal from the 15. Breaks it to the outside, and he is dropped at the 22 by R.J. Jackson. The Buckeyes start in a two-tailback set.
And Brandon Sane at fullback.
Play action. First down, incomplete, and right from the get-go, Beckman knocked to the deck by Ricky Jean Francois. The Buckeyes offensively, all Big Ten performer at left tackle in Alex Boone. A four-year starter in Kirk Barton on the right side. Chris Wells rushed for nearly 1,500 yards as a sophomore. Beckman's favorite target, Brian Robiski, caught 50 passes during the season. This is Chris Wells. He plows ahead out to the 28-yard line. Third down and 5 upcoming for Ohio State. LSU sports the number 3 ranked defense in college football. Their all-world defensive tackle is Glenn Dorsey. Linebacking core, Ali Highsmith, the senior, an All-American, an All-SEC performer in the middle, Derry Beckwith, and Craig Steltz, a first-team All-American at strong safety.
Two tailbacks in the game again. This is Brandon Sane, the second tailback here on the wing. That's Wells moving out.
Empty backfield. Robiski, that is a first down out to the 36-yard line. Wells, a big burst to the outside. Beanie Wells to the 30, the 20. A lunge for a tackle. Touchdown, Buckeyes, 65 yards. 65 yards, a career long touchdown burst for Chris Wells. What a start again in a title game for Ohio State.
Last year, a kickoff return on the opening kick of the game against Florida. Now, early in the game, Beanie Wells goes the distance.
Ryan Pretorius, the point after. We're not even a minute 30 into this All-State BCS National Championship game. And an early blow delivered by the Buckeyes. Chris Wells, 65 yards, 7-0, Ohio State. Booming kick by Petrie. Williams will take a knee in the end zone. Matt Flynn, who patiently waited his turn behind Matt Monk and Jamarcus Russell, his first three seasons at LSU. This is Jacob Hester, and not much running room. Tripped up by Marcus Freeman after a gain of three. The Tigers up front, all SEC performers in black. Johnson, 28 consecutive starts for Helms in the middle. Weapons all over the field. Hester rushed for better than 1,000 yards. A trio of outstanding receivers. Key Singer gets a start at tight end. Richard Dixon will get a lot of playing time. Richard Murphy in back of Hester in the I formation. Play fake to him. Flynn dumps it off, dropped by Early Doucette. Third down and 7. They need to get to the 30. And the snap sails by Flynn, who has to cover it up at his own 5.
He's had a few errors early.
Patrick Fisher punts from his own end zone. Hartline and small weight. What a punt by Fisher, sending Hartline to the 32. Stiff arms his way across to the 40 and spotted at the 41-yard line. A 61-yard punt at their own 41.
Once again, they go empty set.
And Beckman to throw on first down. Wide open, Brandon Sane. Tiptoes down the sideline all the way down to the 15.
The corner tried to jump a hitch, and he got behind him, and Beckman found him.
Now out of the I formation, it's Wells, and he just plows ahead of the 10-yard line. Early movement along the line.
Ball start, 71 offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
And he said that multitasking would not hurt his preparation.
Second and 10, Beckman inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line. Trips to the right, Small and Hartline to the left. Beckman dropped. Maybe a gain of 1.
Coverage. They get to come up and snug up against the receivers and have tighter coverage. That time they cause Beckman to pull it down and run it.
The native South African Pretorius bangs it through the uprights. 9 minutes and 12 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Ohio State 10, LSU nothing. Again, a booming kick into the end zone by Petrie. LSU offense, it became the first in school history to score more than 500 points in a season. This is Jacob Hester. He's out across the 20, maybe picks up a yard, tripped up by Larry Grant.
Got the speed guy in the game now, Trendon Holiday, the 5'5" speedster at the top of the screen.
Hester on the pitch. And this stingy, and we mean stingy.
And Florida, this year, they're even better.
Third and 7, good protection. And a catch by Doucette. They'll move the chains for the first time tonight. Play fake to Scott. Again, Flynn to throw it. Drops it off to his fullback, Quinn Johnson.
Two teams with that exact configuration.
Hand off to Hester. Warren Ida steps up to meet him at the 40. Third and three. Mestre, first down and then some. Across midfield, all the way down to the 40-yard line. A gain of 20. Lynn looking towards the sideline, lofts it into the hands, and making the catch, getting a foot down is Early Doucette to the 24. Doucette takes a handoff and dances his way to the 20-yard line. Hard running inside the 15 for Charles Scott.
Big yards, big play, key plays. Look for him to touch it.
Third and one. Hester. First down yardage to the Ohio State 12. Two tight end set. Doucette in motion, and Flynn going to keep it himself. And nowhere to go.
Trendon Holiday, number eight, in the backfield now.
Flynn, it almost appeared to be a busted play of some kind. And
one receiver is Doucette, number nine, but Brandon LaFell, number one, is a nice target.
I think we can start calling Les Miles an LSU man.
He's definitely an LSU man, and Ohio State likes to play man in this situation in the red zone.
Flynn under heavy heat from Golston, and Hayward has to throw it away.
Nice job by Ohio State forcing Flynn out of the pocket.
A 32-yard field goal try for David out of the hold of Matt Flynn. And the kick is right down the middle. And LSU with 2:21 to play in the opening quarter on the board. Nader Abdallah grew up in New Orleans. Proud of his defense for a big stop a moment ago.
Let's go mano a mano. Let's see who comes out.
Very short kick will be handled by Maurice Wells at the 10. To the 25. To the 27. In a second national title game consecutively here tonight, and this is Chris Wells. And he's to the 33-yard line. Second and five, they pitch it to Wells, who dodges one tackler and spins his way out to the 40, a first down. What a start for Wells. Good protection this time. Wells looking for Hartline, and terrific coverage by Jonathan Zenon. They pitch it to Wells on second down, and this time bottled up after a gain of two.
This is what Ohio State wanted to avoid, getting behind the chains, third and long.
Beckman steps up, and incomplete, looking at Hartline. Hartline looking for a flag, didn't get it. A.J. Trapasso, the Ohio State punter. Chad Jones, the freshman, stands at his own 20. Angle toward the sideline. Jones from the 8. And still on his feet. The 15, the ball is loose. And who's got it? There is a scramble at the 15-yard line. The Buckeyes say they have it.
Everybody's pulling and grabbing, of course. A shoe just came out of the pile. But Marcus Freeman can flat out play on the outside.
Matt Flynn out of shotgun, looking right, throws to Doucette. And he's to the 22-yard line. On the final play of the opening quarter, a gain of six. Ohio State jumped out to a 10-0 lead. LSU comes back, kicks a field goal. 10-3, we move to quarter number two. Off to Hester. Short of the first down. Out of the I formation, they give it to Hester. A first down. Anderson Russell hit him at the 29. And Hester ran through him after a 5-yard gain. Ran for 251 yards and was the MVP of the SEC championship game. He went the distance in place of the injured Flynn.
He's a runner.
The option. He got it away to Keelan Williams. And he's run out of bounds close to a first down. Wow.
Little extra.
After the play, personal foul. Number 92 on the defense. Late hit out of bounds. 15 yards added to the dead ball spot. First down.
Flynn right back in there. Works out of the shotgun. Drops it off to Williams. And the true freshman from Sewanee, Georgia. Loss of a yard. Second and 11. Flynn to a wide open Demetrius Byrd to the 25.
Personal foul. Face mask number 33 on the defense. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
LSU quickly to the line of scrimmage. And a touchdown to Richard Dixon. Coming for Court David, fourth receiving touchdown this season for Dixon. He is an outstanding tight end.
Matt Flynn has a special connection with him, but I love what the man they call the Wizard dialed up there, the offense coordinator Gary Croton, a special formation that made it unbalanced, it appeared, and Richard Dixon on the backside, and they went hurry up before Ohio State had a chance to react. And Dixon takes it into the end zone. Flynn celebrates, and we have a tie ball game. A little bit of sleight of hand with the last formation.
Godet, another very short kick. Way small from the 12-yard line. And he is hammered at the 23.
He's got plenty more in his bag tonight than he wants to use.
Beanie Wells breaks it to the outside across the 30. Just stiff arms Jackson. Crosses midfield. Wow.
Chris Wells trying to join in on that list.
Well, he's passed him tonight for the all-time sophomore single-season rushing record. Beckman to throw on first down. This is Brian Robiski inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Of course, Robiski. Chris Wells again, and this time there to meet him is Christian Pittman.
Against number 48, middle linebacker Derry Beckwith, and Waring was flagged on the play, setting back Ohio State.
Beckman throws to a wide open receiver, Brandon Sane, and he's all the way to the 20-yard line. Third and three, empty backfield. Beckman lofts it to the end zone. Touchdown, Robiski. No! They say it sprung loose. It looked like he had it momentarily. And then that ball came out of there. And Stelz is still in a great deal of pain.
And it hurt them in coverage because of his pain. He was late getting to an assignment, and it ended up one-on-one. He was the deep safety on this play. Not able to come over and help out Shevis Jackson on the short side. Watching for the fake.
No fake, and it's blocked by LSU. Beckless got it at the 35. It looked like Jean-Francois got a paw on the football.
The fourth block this year of a Pretorius kick. And Ricky Jean-Francois, number 90, barrels through, knocks over Ben Person, number 63, and gets his right paw up in the air and swats it away. He gets the leverage on Person, knocks him back into the backfield, and bats the field goal down. The SEC title game this season.
Clearly, the momentum has swung to the Bengal Tigers. And all the way out to the 48-yard line.
Offensive line is really starting to move the defensive front of Ohio State.
They run the option. Golston doesn't take the bait, but had no help behind him. And the pitch goes to Richard Murphy in it. Second and about a yard and a half at the Ohio State 45. Play fake to Keelan Williams, lobbing down the sideline. Incomplete. Malcolm Jenkins, number two, step for step with Demetrius Byrd, number two. And on third and less than two, Flynn, a short drop. And there's a tight end. This time it's Singer inside the 30 to the 28. They're saying the ground caused the fumble. That is a first down for LSU.
Exactly what Matt Flynn did.
First and 10 Tigers from the 26. Quarterback keeper for Flynn. And coming off that shoulder injury, you're blocking an Ohio State field goal attempt a moment ago. They pitch it to Holiday, cuts it back the other way. And Chekwa trips him up at the 16, very close to a first down.
Of course, who's back there? Hester, number 18.
Flynn on the keeper to the 15. That is a first down for LSU.
As well as Gary Croton's formations, limiting what Ohio State can do to attack defensively.
Batted down by Grant. Play clock down to 2-1. They just do get it off. Flynn to keep it. And he's to the 10-yard line.
Try and create man coverage.
Flynn rolling left. Lofts it to the end zone. Touchdown, LaFell. Fourth touchdown reception of the season. Point after by Colt David is good. 17 unanswered points for the LSU Tigers. Back to back to back outstanding drives. Capped off by the touchdown and a 7-point LSU lead. You're watching the All-State BCS National Championship on Fox. LSU, its first lead of the night. Godet's kick will be fielded by Ray Small at the 10-yard line. And still on his feet, crossing the 30 out to the 31. Important drive offensively for Ohio State.
Agreed.
Chris Wells met at the line of scrimmage. Greg Stelz has not come back on the field defensively for LSU. Harry Coleman, 24, replaces him in the secondary. Beckman to throw. And completing at an eye on heart line. And a flag comes in.
Try and use that big defensive front against Todd Beckman.
Brandon Sane in motion. And they're coming after Beckman, who lofts it to the far side. And it is intercepted by Chevis Jackson to the 30, the 25, and run out of bounds. Well, now LSU trying to add to a 7-point lead. Flynn, good protection, steps up, delivers a strike to the 15-yard line.
Playbook wide open on second and short here.
Flynn rolls, looks back the other way. Wide open is Dixon to the 5 and to the 1-yard line.
Inside the 1.
They hand it on first down, and leaping into the air is Hester, and he is chucked down by Laurinaitis. Hester denied the end zone for a second straight try, met head on by Dexter Larimore.
For Hester, or the play fake and find a tight end.
Gonna hand it to Hester, and he is met at the goal line. No signal given yet, and now a touchdown for LSU.
Got in on sheer second effort there. The one thing about Jacob Hester, hard to knock him backwards. Watch the first effort, stymied at the line of scrimmage. Right there, he's met. Looks like Laurinaitis. But then as he turns, watch him wiggle and move his body and turn and fall and stay with it. And now he falls right on the goal line. Touchdown, LSU.
Point after attempt by Colt David. Good snap, good hold, good kick. 24 unanswered points from the LSU Tigers. And they lead by 14, 24-10, or 16 to play until halftime.
Oval in the pocket.
Small from his own 11-yard line, bobbles it once, picks it cleanly, and tries to go to the left and turn the corner and is denied.
We had a blast meeting with him, and he's such a great football player. His wife allows him to keep a bust of Elvis in the house.
Beckman to throw on first down, and nearly intercepted. Was the catch made? No. They pitch it to Wells on the short field, and he picks up maybe two. They're coming after Beckman, who throws to Hartline. He turns the corner, and that's good enough for an Ohio State first down, and boy, do the Buckeyes need that.
It was abysmal weather. I give a little bit of a free pass there, but Illinois was not effective at all.
And around from Hartline. He's tripped up out to the 39-yard line. Beckman in trouble. Down he goes. The ball is loose. Third down and 13.
But now they're bunched up in there showing the blitz.
Slant to Hartline, but nowhere near first down yardage. LSU in front 24-10. Ohio State to punt it away. A.J. Trapasso will send Jones back inside the five and into the end zone. Well, now with under a minute and no more timeouts, does LSU try to go down the field and tack on?
They want to see what they get on the first play. Since they didn't get much there, I think they're just going to go ahead and tuck it in.
What an amazing turn of events. After that early 10-0 Ohio State lead, 24 unanswered points against Ohio State's number one ranked defense. So we've reached the intermission of this All-State BCS National Championship game. The LSU Tigers in front, 24-10. LSU to get the football to begin the second half. Ohio State, if you're just joining us, jumped in front in this game 10-0. They have given up 24 points since without an answer. Trendon Holiday will take it deep.
Through the Ohio State defense again. That'd be very, very difficult for Ohio State to handle.
Early do set in motion. They pitch it to Keelan Williams. Cuts it back to the inside. A big gainer on first down of nearly 10. Good protection across the middle. A one-handed catch made by Brandon LaFell. Coverage and the tackle by James Laurinaitis.
Remember, run game is his strongest attribute.
He only played one play in the first half. It was an option. This time he fakes the pitch and is very close to another first down. Third and a yard. They're going to give it to Hester. And he has a first down.
Taking them out of their game plan.
Holiday takes a pitch, forced back to the inside, and is very close to another first down. Flynn finds a little crease and is into Ohio State territory. And they pitch it to him. And he is clotheslined by Larry Grant. And thrown down after a gain of, we'll call it two. Flynn out of a shotgun on second down and 8. Opening drive of the second half for LSU. Under pressure, and Flynn will throw it away. And the OSU sideline screaming intentional grounding in their right.
He was not out of the tackle box.
Intentional grounding, 15 on the offense. Penalty is lost and down at the spot of the foul. Third down.
But he watches as his defense needs to make a play. Third and 23. Flynn rolls and just throws it right into the ground under heavy pressure from Marcus Freeman. Ray Small. As it was nearly blocked and a flag comes down. This will be roughing the kicker. Personal foul, the fourth of the game against Ohio State.
15-yard penalty, first down.
And that is an automatic first down. So now the defense right back on the field after thinking it had done its job.
Looks like that's going against Cameron Hayward, number 97. He got into it at the end of the play. He picks up another personal foul. Turns up most penalties and still won a national championship. Pistol formation again.
Lester slips one tackle, breaks another, still on his feet, down to the 20-yard line. Flynn to throw. And the screen is set up to Charles Scott. Breaking defenders inside the five, down to the four.
That guy's going to make a play for it.
Play fake one way. Flynn rolls, dumps it off to Early Doucette. And he's still on his feet and dances into the end zone. Missed tackles by Anderson Russell and Donald Washington. What a devastating blow after you had him stopped. A roughing the kicker gave him an automatic first down. And cap it off with a touchdown.
And add to it a little lack of poise. Cameron Hayward, the freshman, picks up the personal foul. And I think there's a little spirit leaving this Ohio State team. This is a team that we saw during the season. Didn't miss very many tackles, especially ones not like that. They prided themselves on being good tacklers. On that play, it certainly did not appear to be so. Early Doucette with a big move and a touchdown.
0-4 to play in the third quarter. LSU in search of its third national championship, 1958. And then here in this building in 2003 under then head coach Nick Saban. Gray Small from the 13. And good kickoff coverage all night tonight for LSU. 31-10. Chris Wells will carry it out to the 32-yard line. Wells in motion. Beckman to throw on second down. And wide open field in front of him. To the 35, the 40, the 45 midfield, and steps out of bounds at the LSU 48-yard line.
Said if he gets feeling back on that right side, I'll put him in, but don't count on it.
Wells on first down, runs right in to Ricky Jean Francois.
Notice LSU staying in base defense, knowing Ohio State will continue to try and run the ball, too.
Beckman rolls, throws to Sane. A catch and maybe a gain of two. Well split far to the right. And Beckman has to eat it. Boy, he had two wide open receivers and did not see either one of them. A.J. Trapasso wanted to punt it away for Ohio State. We're under 6 minutes here in the third quarter. And LSU leading by three scores. Good punt by Trapasso, and they'll spot it at the 11-yard line. LSU in front in the All-State BCS National Championship game, 31-10. As Tigers drive begins at the 10. And a misread there. Could have been that punt.
That was huge right there.
Woulda, coulda, shoulda. Hester out across the 15. Four receivers set. Hester in the backfield standing next to Flynn on third down. We'll call it four. A slant. First down to the tight end, Dixon. Out to the 28-yard line.
That's happening.
Lock continuing to run. Another first down, and they hand it to Hester, who breaks a couple of tackles, and he picks up two.
And waiting
for this night to play. And an interception by Malcolm Jenkins. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown. No, they're saying he stepped out of bounds at the 11-yard line. But you said it, Charles. They had to have a play to get back in this thing. And that's a play for Ohio State trying to get back in it.
And they have to score six on this possession.
Chris Wells down to the 6-yard line.
Yeah, a field goal here is a win for LSU. Has to be six for the Buckeyes.
And again, they'll turn and hand it to Chris Wells, and he's inside the five. And Wells one more time, and he's denied into the backfield. Ricky Jean-Francois, and now Jim Tressel on fourth down. A must conversion. They can get a first down. Beckman throws, and it is a touchdown to Brian Robiski. So on fourth down from the five, Ohio State into the end zone to make it a two-touchdown spread.
That was a big league pickup. Because I'll be frank, I did not think a fourth and five, they were going to be able to get the ball in the end zone against that LSU defense. Gutsy pickup by the Ohio State Buckeyes.
So now Ryan Pretorius for the point after. Out of the hold of John Toma, and it is good. So some life pumped back into this number one ranked Ohio State Buckeyes team. The interception by Jenkins capped off a touchdown pass. What a catch by Robiski. 31-17, LSU.
Having won many of them this evening in critical junctures, they did there.
Madrid puts a foot on it, chasing Holiday back to the goal line. And the fastest man in college football out across the 20 and wrapped up at the 28-yard line.
Paul Dietzel, head coach there. We can talk about him all night and his innovations here at LSU. Still felt today.
Flynn will run it on first down, and he is hammered by the combination of Marcus Freeman and Malcolm Jenkins. Ohio State showing blitz. And they hand it off to Doucette. And he is stopped shy of the 35. Third down and six coming up. Comes up with an interception and a touchdown. The All-State BCS National Championship game continues after these messages from your local Fox station.
Church your pass rush because you're only rushing four against five blockers.
Flynn with time, and he'll have to eat it, denied the first down. Really, you think about it, were it not for the roughing the kicker, that is now three straight defensive stops.
Made Matt Flynn eat the football and forced another punt, and I'm sure a return is on now for Ohio State, not a block.
What a punt by Fisher. He has had a great night, and that one is into the end zone.
Establish a rhythm on offense, but LSU equally important for them on defense. Their team follows their lead in how the defense plays.
Trying to lead the charge offensively and get him back in this. He delivers a strike over the middle to Brian Hartline. That's a first down out to the 40-yard line. I hand it to Wells. He slips to the outside. Dances over one tackler, and that's close to a 10-yard pickup for Wells. It is a first down run, a gain of 10 for Wells. Play action. Beckman looking across the middle. It's caught by Robiski. Another first down to the LSU 37-yard line.
Who has stressed the educational aspect. Brian Robiski, a first-team academic All-American.
Lofted down the sideline with an A on Ray Small. And second down and 10. The LSU 37-yard line. Play fake to Wells. Beckman dancing around and breaks to the outside and takes a hit. Ball comes loose. He was starting to slide, and right when he went into a slide.
Sliding.
Third down and four. Beckman. Down he goes. He was looking initially at Robiski when he was covered. Fourth and seven. Beckman pump fake, rolls right, and is hammered. The ball is loose. Still a scramble, picked up by LSU. All the way to the 34-yard line. Stripped by Ali Highsmith, and picked up by Harry Coleman. Official Terry Turlington reviewing to see if this
After
was a pass.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It was a fumble. LSU takes possession. However, there was also a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on LSU. That'll be penalized 15 yards from the dead ball spot. LSU, first down.
As LSU goes back to the pistol formation.
And they give it to Hester. And he's inside the 45, down to the 43-yard line. Under center out of the I formation this time, and Hester to the 41-yard line. A third down upcoming. Third down, and they're sending a house on Flynn. Ball batted down at the line of scrimmage by Cameron Hayward. The All-State BCS National Championship Trophy presentation, and the most outstanding players will be announced. High punt by Fisher, and it bounces. That's into the end zone.
See,
but again, Ohio State has fallen behind and not handed the ball off much. Give it to Wells on first down, and he'll pick up close to four. Wells splits far to the left. Empty backfield. And Beckman fires to Robiski. And he needed to get to the 30 for a first down. Looks to be a little bit short.
And then they come out quickly out of a tight formation. Or into a tight formation. They didn't get it.
And Wells denied the first down. Ohio State going to have to go with 7.5 minutes left. Trail lead a yard, maybe a little less than a yard. Two tight ends. They give it to Wells. And he appears to have enough for a first down. Out of the shotgun, Beckman throws. And was the catch made? Yes, out to the 44 by Ray Small. Beckman hit from behind. And he covered the football. Dorsey, we have not called his name much tonight.
Just think that they'd be a little more high tempo and still huddle, but you have to increase the pace.
In and out of the hands of Brian Hartline.
Bo Pelini tells his team you have to earn the right to rush the passer on third down. Well, third and 15 gives them that right.
Beckman intercepted by Curtis Taylor. And a celebration begins in the Bayou. Three to play and a two touchdown lead. And they're going to throw it. Early new set on first down. And he is out of bounds. A very surprising A, they're throwing, and B, that you're running out of bounds.
I think we'll see a little more of Hester in this situation.
Well, they fake the handoff to Hester, and then Flynn going to keep it himself. Picks up two. Man, that guy was a player, Brady James.
Yes, he was. He's the first AP All-American since Michael Brooks in 1986.
Throw it to Doucette. And did he get enough for a first down?
It's going to be a close. Depends on where the foot goes on the spot. They've run sneak here before.
And they do again. And they do to convert. Of course, it was that Florida game.
LSU went ahead. Continued their march.
Lynn lets that play clock roll all the way down to two before the snap. They hand it off to Hester.
Hard to argue that it's not the most impressive era of football for LSU. And frankly, hard to say that there's an end in sight.
Lynn picks up another first down to the 30-yard line here in the national championship game. There's a pitch to Murphy to the inside. And still on his feet. Down to the 7-yard line. Let's not forget Les Miles. Flynn to hand it off. And that is Scott Met at the 5-yard line. Under 2.5 minutes to go. Flynn rolls. Wide open is Dixon. David is good. And you think the streets.
The guy overcame having to wear braces on his legs as a child, unable to play while the other children were playing. Until his legs got stronger.
Small out to the 40, still on his feet to the 46-yard line.
Depending on whether a number of guys will take early entry, they could very well be right back in this game next year.
Bump more a freshman or a redshirt freshman.
Exactly. They could come back with the same cast of characters with a year's extra experience. They'll have interference on the play. The coverage looked like Jai Eugene.
Only USC has a better record over the last seven seasons overall.
Yeah, unfortunately, it was the national stage, and everyone took that as that was the whole thing of the program. Not really true. If you look at LSU now, trying to become one of those elite programs that you talk about year in and year out. And he hopes to have his shot, as do a number of teams, but they'll be right there doing battle.
Lofted into the end zone. Robisky up into the air, caught it, but out of bounds.
Jambalaya Festival every year.
Sounds good. Slant by Hartline, and he will race into the end zone for a touchdown. With 1:13 left, makes it a 38-24 game with a point after.
And go kick the extra point, and then you know we're going to line up for an onside kick. There's no way Jim Tressel is playing this thing out, not going to play this thing out. There's just no way. That's not part of who he is, nor would Les Miles do it the same way on the other side. Nice throw by Beckman. Well thrown ball. Hartline with the catch. Breaks a tackle and gets into the end zone.
Pretorius with a point after to make it a 14-point spread with 1:13 to go. Our executive producers at Fox Sports, Ed Gorn and David Hill, our thanks to our entire crew on this onside kick. A heavy lift delivered by Malcolm Jenkins. But Charles Scott hangs onto the football.
Exactly what Charles Scott has done all year long.
Starting to see the emotion now from Les Miles, 54-year-old.
Remember, they decided they pulled the black shirts tradition last year, so they could get it back. So they needed one thing to feel good about. And LSU football has been something they felt good about for a long time, and that helped a number of people through a very, very difficult situation.
Well, congratulations to the LSU Tigers. The 2008 All-State BCS National Champions. Let's send it downstairs to Chris Myers.
With senior Glenn Dorsey, and have you seen the papers? LSU number one. Congratulations. What was the difference in the game?
I think we had to get over that first. You know, they came out ready to play, and we just want to sustain that and overcome it and stay within ourselves and play hard.
Were you a little bit nervous to start the game, this team?
I'm always nervous before a game. That's how I know I'm ready. And my team came out and played hard.
There was a chance you might not come back for your senior season. You went through some injuries. You fought hard. Are you glad you did?
Without a doubt, my team is the number one team in the land, man. Right now, it's great to be an LSU Tiger. I love it. I love my hometown because I love Battle Royale. I'm great to be a Tiger.
All right, well, there'll be some celebrating tonight. Congratulations. We'll see you in the NFL.
Thanks, man. Y'all take it easy. Thank y'all.
All right. Glenn Dorsey. Tom?
Thank you very much, and thank you, Mr. Dorsey. Doesn't matter if he's going to be playing pro football or not. That young man would be successful whatever avenue he were to take in life ahead. 38-24, LSU defeats Ohio State to win the national championship of college football.
Ladies and gentlemen on the field, Fox Sports, Chris Rose.
Thank you very much. Time right now for the trophy presentation. I want to welcome to the stage from Allstate, Tom Wilson. From the Sugar Bowl, Ray Gendron, Paul Holohan, and from DirecTV, John Gieselman. Gentlemen, welcome. And it is time right now to present the BCS Coaches Trophy presented by DirecTV. For that, I welcome in from the BCS, the commissioner of the ACC, John Swofford. John.
Thank you, Chris. First of all, on behalf of the institutions and the 11 conferences that make up the BCS, let me congratulate both teams on tremendous seasons and their effort tonight. And now, On behalf of the American Football Coaches Association, it's my pleasure to present the Coach's Trophy, symbolic of the national championship, to Coach Les Miles and the LSU Tigers.
Go for it. Coach, I know it's a big party up here. I know you want to go celebrate with your kids. It has been an amazing year for you guys. So many close games, triple overtime losses. You've had to dispel rumor, call impromptu news conferences. What did you learn about your kids that you didn't know about them back in August?
Nothing. I knew they were competitive. I knew they'd fight like hell. I knew they would win. We had great confidence. I can only tell you, by the grace of God, we're here. But once we got here, we were going to do our best.
Three straight 11-win seasons for LSU. Two national championships in the last five seasons. Have the Tigers become the dominant team in college football?
Very humbly, it's one of the great programs in college football. It's a great place to get an education, great place to win championships.
We talked about it last year when you stood on stage after your victory in the All-State Sugar Bowl, what it meant to the people of New Orleans and Louisiana, the entire South, and dealing with Hurricane Katrina. I imagine having about 50,000 of your closest friends here tonight didn't hurt, right?
We enjoy playing in this arena. We enjoy playing in front of the state of Louisiana and the great people of LSU, I promise you.
Coach, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Chris.
Time right now to give out the individual honors. The offensive MVP of the game, Matt Flynn. Not a bad way to end your college career.
Yeah, it's not bad at all. It's pretty sweet. A dream come true, it really is.
Listen, you had to bide your time behind Matt Mauch and then Jamarcus Russell as well. Did you ever think that, you know, starting at LSU, let alone winning a national championship, was a possibility for this kid from Tyler, Texas?
You know, I never knew, but I dreamt, you know. And, you know, I feel extremely blessed to have this last year and to be a part of such a great team and great guys and have such great fans support us. And, you know, we just feel honored to be here and get this opportunity.
You know, you guys went against the number one defense in the entire country. How were you able to almost drop 40 on them?
Well, just execution. We came out here with the right frame of mind, and, you know, we prepared well. You know, we had a bunch of weeks to prepare for this game, and, you know, we just came out here and executed and just kept hanging in there. And, you know, I give it to our offensive line and the receivers blocking out in the perimeter. They did a great job, and, you know, they're the reason we're standing here.
Career high four TD tosses. Matt Flynn, congratulations on that. Time right now for defensive MVP honors, and that goes to a sophomore, Ricky Jean Francois. Come on up here, big boy. I don't think there's a question that your field goal block, when it was 10-10, swung the momentum of this game. After that, you guys scored 21 straight points. Was that the big changing point?
I believe so. I believe that was the changing point. Before that, my coach told me, Ricky, just get down low as you can and just come full speed and try to block it. You might don't, but at least you try it. When I did my best, I blocked it, and I was just hoping somebody just picked it up from my team.
Yeah, show me those big hands. Those are big. Yeah, that's not fair. All right, listen, for you personally, it's been a trying season. You were suspended the first 12 games because of some off-field issues. What'd you learn about yourself?
It made me start appreciating everything, my school, my football, my family, everybody around me, my coaches, my friends. It just made me appreciate everything. So when I look at everything now, I'm going to appreciate it. I ain't going to take it for granted no more.
Well, obviously good thoughts on that one. Take those big hands and put it on that championship trophy, my friend. Congratulations. LSU, the first school to win two BCS national championships. Tom Brenneman, take it away.
Chris, thank you very much. They will be celebrating deep into the night in New Orleans. Les Miles, many thought he was going to Michigan to try and win a championship. Not so. He's an LSU man.